Okay, let's jump straight in with the Cthonian one of two. So I'm gonna try this awesomely looking Caribbean ocean. I mean, look at it. This is gorgeous. I'm gonna apply this to the body. And we're using an enormous brush for this. This guy is pretty straightforward. There are not a lot of areas, so I probably could have painted him really, really quickly. And I probably could have stopped after 15 minutes or so when all the areas were covered. I do go on for a little bit though, and adding some highlights and shade and finishing touches. This paint looks pretty blue with my camera right now, but it's actually slightly more green, slightly more teal in reality. I'm gonna try to capture some other images or footage at the end of the video to show it in a better setting. Just try to imagine that it's a little bit more teal. I forgot to press record, but you just missed a few strokes. I'm using the Fire Giant Orange from the original speed paint set for this. The idea is to use the reactivation property and try to remove some of the paint later on. I suppose this wouldn't be an Armada Minis video unless paint was running all over the place. So, mission accomplished. This cleaning up isn't really going that well, but I think we can add some more paint and try to cover up this mess. Now we're gonna apply some gray Lorne gray to the ground there. I suppose it looks like rubble or something, so just a plain gray. I think he actually looks pretty good at this point, so you can probably stop right here if you wanted to. If it hadn't been for a few of those mistakes, I mean, this would have been a 10-minute paint job, excluding the preparations, of course. But that's pretty cool. Well, I'm gonna push a few more things, some highlights and some shade and some details. I'm gonna use Plasmatic Bolt from the original speed paint set, and this is greener and maybe a little bit darker than the color I just used for the body. So I'm gonna try to use this both as a shade but also to enforce some greenness to mostly the underside of his body, the shaded side. Now, there aren't a lot of details on this guy, but on the tentacles there are suction cups, so I'm gonna paint them ivory. I think we can improve some contrast here on the body. So I'm gonna whip out a dry brush and add some ivory while I have that on the palette. It's really tricky to get the focus right when I'm using these bigger models. I'm working on that. But yeah, there's a slight difference. Not that much, but it's a little bit lighter. To emphasize it a little further, I'm gonna dry brush some white ever so slightly. Now I'm just gonna use a damp brush and try to dab off a little bit, rub off a little bit of the paint, hoping that the reactivation will work to my advantage. But not that much is coming off, but a little bit. Now, with a better camera setting, you can actually see the teal color here. This is how it actually looks. And so now I'm just using a damp brush to just water this down a little bit, because I'm going to try to add nuclear sunrise as some sort of darker color for the beginning of the tentacles here. So I'm guessing that some water here, if I pre-dampen them, it's gonna make it easier to get a smooth transition. I'm gonna try. I'm not really happy with the dry brushing. I mean, it looks awesome. I just feel that I should do a little bit more of white on the main body. I'm also gonna whiten up the base a little bit, that rubble stuff on the base. I mean, the preparation with the dry brushing and all works just fine, but I just wanna make that rubble pop a little bit more. Now I'm gonna add some selective gloss varnish here to a few parts of the tentacles. This is Citadel's Ard Coat, and I'm gonna try to just apply it to what I think would be the most reflective areas, looking pretty much straight forward at the model, looking straight at the model. Now I have applied off camera. I've applied a varnish, a matte varnish, and removed him from the temporary base. So he is done. And I'm really happy with this result. Thank you. Bye.